Hello, it's Ricardo, and welcome back to Elite Dangerous. A little different type of video this week. In regards to Elite Dangerous, we're going to talk about what happens when your key bindings get lost and how you can never lose those key bindings again by following a simple little process. Welcome back, Commanders, and this is an age-old problem we've got here in regards to how the Elite Dangerous game works. Now, if you've got a joystick or you play with a controller on PC, you may well have had this problem. The problem is that if everything is plugged in and everything's working fine and Windows is doing its thing, everything works perfectly. Your key bindings are there. However, a problem does exist that if you load the game without that controller plugged in, for example, perhaps the cable has fallen out the back of your X52 or you've unplugged your controller because you've got a USB drive in there, whatever, Elite Dangerous will default to another preset. For example, keyboard and mouse. And the second you make a change to this one, your previous custom file will be overwritten. But we have a solution from our very own Commander Simon. Commander Simon's an active person in the streams on the weekend and an integral member of the squadron, if not our squadron leader. And he's come up with this guide, which he's kindly asked me to put into a video. So if you've ever started Elite Dangerous, only to find all your custom controller settings are gone, the pixies have had them, then this is the guide for you. So what we're going to do is we're going to stop using the custom keybind, and instead what we're going to do is create our own file, which the game won't delete or replace. Now let's get cracking. Get yourself into Windows File Explorer, and you're going to go to the following directory that I'm going to put up on the screen. We'll put it in the comments as well. Local app data, %/frontier-development/elite-dangerous/options/bindings. This is where the bindings files are kept. Now, once you've got there, and we'll keep this up on the screen, you're going to be looking for the custom bindings file. Now, custom 3 binds is for Horizons, and custom 4 binds is for Odyssey. Now, I've got several files in here because I've backed mine up, because I've had problems before. So I'll delete those just for a little bit of clarity whilst doing these videos. So this is what you're going to see, custom 3 binds and custom 4 binds. Now, here's an important note. If you don't see the custom.3 binds and the custom.4 binds, and you're a new commander, this typically means you haven't made any modifications to your key bindings and you're playing them stock. So go in, make some adjustments, and those files will pop up. Anyway, back on with what we were doing. So we've got our custom 3 binds, we've got our custom 4 binds. We're going to select them in File Explorer, we're going to right click, we're going to click copy. I'm using Windows 11, it's slightly different from Windows 10, but Control C, Control V will also do the same options as a keyboard shortcut, no matter what version of Windows you're using. So here we've got our two bindings, and they've got copy written after them. Now you can rename these, so we're going to put the words my in front of them, just to differentiate them a little bit more from the stock files that are in the folder. We're going to take the copy off the back, because we don't need these, because we just put the my in front of them. So the version 3, like I say, is for Horizons, and version 4 is for Odyssey, depending on what you're playing. So we're going to rename the version 4 file, which is the Odyssey file as well, put the words, the prefix my in front of it, and then the suffix, we're going to get rid of that copy, but we're still going to leave the .binds extension at the end. This is going to tell Elite Dangerous that this is a new file, okay, and it's a relatively good bind file. Now we've got those, we're going to double click on binds 3, my binds 3. This is the duplicate file that we've just created, and we're going to bring it into Explorer. Now we're going to make this a bit bigger because it's a bit of an eye test, using Control Z to zoom in and the mouse wheel, and you can see at the top of this particular file there is root preset name custom, and then in quotes, and then it was major version 3. So this is the Horizons file we're going to be altering. What we're going to do is we're going to go to that particular line, you can see I've highlighted on the screen there, and where it's got the quotes and the word custom, we're going to put in there something a bit meaningful. For example, I'm going to call this Ricardo There you go. Perhaps I'll even spell it correctly with the correct capitalization. Here we go. Ricardos version 3. Thank you very much. Horizons. So I know what this file is actually for. When I go into game, that's what's going to show up in the key binding section. So there you go. You can put underscores in there. I would typically avoid any spaces, and we've confirmed that with Simon as well. So keep it all one word. You can use underscore as well, because that typically classes as one word. Right, so what you're going to do now is you're going to save that file. Then you're going to go into custom binds version 4, which is the Odyssey file. Same sort of malarkey again. Just make it a little bit bigger. We're after the root preset name, and you can see it's custom. Now, just for continuity, I'm going to call it exactly the same thing, Ricardos 4. Now, the version 4 is obviously Odyssey. We're going to change that to Odyssey, and we're going to put a few underscores in just to make it a little bit tidier. You can call it what you want, but like we say, do not use any spaces. Once you've done that, file, save again. There you go. And then you've got two adjusted bindings files in that folder, which Elite Dangerous, when you fire it up, is going to recognize. Now, here's the good bit. Into the game. Here's the game. Right? We closed the game down, we restarted it. Into controls. What you're going to do? Into general, and you can see there's the custom keybind, but there's our new bindings files that we renamed. So I play Odyssey, so I'm going to use Ricardos V4 Odyssey and apply it, and we're going to apply it to every section of controls in this game. General, ship, SRV, and on foot. Now, this means that if my controller gets unplugged, it's not going to make the blindest bit of difference. Now, what you might find if they do something drastic with the game, which happens from time to time, you may have to go back in and reapply these presets. But by doing this, this ensures that if anything funky does happen and your controller is disconnected, your key bindings are there no matter what happens, because you're not adjusting that custom file. You're actually doing one that you've created yourself. Pretty simple, hey? All we're doing, we're going in saying, right, we're renaming those files in the bindings folder, the local app data Frontier Development's Elite Dangerous Options bindings folder. We're renaming them, we're changing them in Notepad to read a meaningful name like Ricardos V3 Horizons, and we're applying them to the key binding sections in the game. That's all we're typically doing. If you found this guide particularly useful, I would appreciate if you hit that like and subscribe button. It goes a long way in letting us know what you think is important in regards to Elite Dangerous and what sort of videos you'd like to see in the future. Thanks very much from myself and Commander Simon. I really do hope you found it useful. See you soon in the next video.